Kristen Krozek says, I have familial hypercholesterolemia as well as a mutation in my LP little a. I listened to your 2016 podcast regarding FH and have implemented a low-fat diet and am in the process of fixing thyroid issues. My question is, can you please further explain whether I should be more concerned about overall fat or saturated fat intake? Okay, so you know, just to be clear, I'm not treating anyone here. I'm not a medical practitioner, so I am not treating the disease of familial hypercholesterolemia, and this is just educational in nature. But as a general principle, if I'm thinking about familial hypercholesterolemia and I'm thinking about overall fat or saturated fat, yeah, I would be thinking more about saturated fat, but I would be testing it. So first of all, it depends on the specific saturated fatty acid, but saturated fat relative to other fats raises cholesterol levels. There are people that dispute that, but the data are super, super clear. That does not mean that everyone should lower their saturated fat intake, because probably most people can accommodate that, right? Because most people have a working system to regulate the cholesterol levels. The thing is, with the familial hypercholesterolemia, that system is broken. So you become hypersensitive to all the things that do have some effect. So you will be hypersensitive to the fact that saturated fat raises cholesterol levels more than other fats do. But I think it's more to the root of the problem based on how these things regulate LDL receptor activity, which is what clears cholesterol from your blood and which is what is broken in FH, familial hypercholesterolemia. I think a lower fat, higher carbohydrate diet is more relevant to the root mechanism. But what you do is you test this, right? So standard lipid panels are dirt cheap and it is not hard to convince your doctor to order them, right? So you just, if you're too, like, you don't need to get fancy. You don't need the NMR and all that other stuff. I'm not saying it doesn't have its place, but if you want to do dietary tests to see what are the big factors affecting you, you just run these tests every couple of months and you pick a diet to go on and stay on it for 4 to 8 weeks and then see what the results are, right? So you do the low fat diet where most of your fat comes from coconut, which is the ketogenic diet where they don't have heart disease. And you try that for 4 or 8 weeks and you look at your cholesterol levels, then you do the low fat diet where most of your fat comes from olive oil, which is a more Mediterranean approach. And you see what that does to your cholesterol levels. So you then tailor it to your own response, because I can predict what will generally happen, but the individual person is going to have so many different genetic and other factors that influence what they're responsive to, that they just need to test it out.